Thanks for joining us here on the web. I'm Kristen Carosa, State of Addiction Now. In just hours, a major announcement coming from the White House. President Trump is expected to declare the opioid crisis a nationwide public health emergency. Governor Kristi Noem and Manchester's fire chief will both be in Washington, D.C. for the announcement. This declaration won't bring new dollars to fight this epidemic, but it is expected to expand access to medical services in rural places. Here in Manchester, there are now more resources available for those dealing with substance abuse. A ribbon cutting was held just this morning to celebrate the Farnham Center's new outpatient clinic. WMUR's Ray Brewer joins us to explain why this is much more than just expanding their space.
The director of Easter Seals, which oversees the Farnham Center, says when they first began dealing with recovery, they were meeting in basement rooms, that this new building represents the fulfillment of a dream.
I hope and trust that they feel dignified and respected.
With Mayor Ted Gatsis wielding the scissors, a new outpatient center for those struggling with addiction officially opened in Manchester. The center more than doubles the space available for help.
We have opened up 24 offices here where we had 10 at the old Farnham.
The expanded space means that not only will more people be able to get help, but also new services will be available.
I get a call every day about somebody whose family member has passed, or what do they do? How can they help?
Dr. Cheryl Wilkie says this new space will allow them to do a lot more family education, something they were unable to fit into any of their buildings. The center also includes its own lab, so they can do drug testing on site. The outpatient facility is located at 700 Lake Avenue, and the hope is that this will also be easier for people to get to.
Obviously, this is a very accessible part of the city. There's bus stops nearby. It's walking distance, bike riding distance to most areas of the city.
Those struggling with addiction can walk in without an appointment from 8 to 10 in the morning and 1 to 3 in the afternoon. Kathleen Murphy says that when someone walks through the door, she doesn't want them to worry about being lectured.
We're focusing on helping guide clients back toward their own insights about what they need to do in their lives. We're not telling clients what to do.
One thing the directors want to stress is that these programs are open to anyone, regardless of financial need. That this program is about saving lives. In Manchester, Ray Brewer, WMUR News 9.
And don't forget that Drug Takeback Day is a Saturday from 10 until 2. There are more than 100 drop-off locations across the state. In Manchester, the fire department will pick up medications for people who can't get to drop-off sites because of a disability or medical condition. You have to schedule that pickup by tomorrow. Simply call the Manchester Fire Department at 669-2256. Just into the newsroom, an arrest in the investigation into several attempted burglaries at UNH in Durham. The university police just announced Frederick Apt was arrested for allegedly loitering and prowling, and later determined he was also involved in several attempted burglaries at residential housing facilities on and off campus. Police say Mr. Apt is not a student but lives locally. After reports of incidents earlier this school year, the Oyster River School District is now stepping up efforts to address and stop racism. Hundreds of people attended a diversity forum last night in Durham, sharing experiences and urging everyone to talk about issues face to face. The parents of two children targeted in the school district discussed their situation and did show letters of support they received from across the country and the state.
The community has reached out to us in love and support, and that has really helped us to overcome our feelings of just hate, of fear.
We know deep in our hearts and as a reality that there are loving, kind people right here in New Hampshire.
All staff members in the Oyster River School District are also getting diversity training. Right now, a crash in Groveton is under investigation. State police say they were called to the scene on Route 3 shortly after 8 last night. We're told two vehicles were involved in the crash and at least one person was taken to the hospital. Happening now, three Dartmouth College professors are on paid leave. The Ivy League school says it restricted the professors' access to campus pending the conclusion of ongoing investigations into allegations of, quote, serious misconduct. At this time, details surrounding the allegations are not being released. Starting tonight at 5, we will have complete coverage of President Trump's opioid announcement this afternoon and what it means for New Hampshire. Plus, would you pay different prices at the movie theater depending on how popular the movie is? It's an idea being tested right now. That does it for us here on the web. Have a great afternoon.